I told y'all to chill out. Welcome to Jay Explains, fam. I'm Jay, the official elected official, and my home state of New Jersey has just canceled a vote on legal adult use cannabis. Now, if you're a sub, then you know this topic is a channel staple that's really driven a lot of the content because our hometown, Irvington, much like all of urban America, fell victim to the drug war, and marijuana legalization is a step away from that plague on our communities. But as previously stated, multiple times, at great length, what New Jersey Dems are pushing is a corporate construct disguised as a social justice endeavor. So where we can take what we can get, we can't be heartbroken that this didn't go through. Pressing the urban equity and getting these communities licenses was merely hedging our bets. If it had passed, there were measures in place to ensure that the hood wasn't completely left in the cold, which was a major goal when we began our advocacy 3 years ago. But once the idea got too big to contain, the wheels fell off, and there were many of my fellow black electeds demanding expungement, and Sweeney himself coming out and saying how it was all about social justice, which is the lie of all lies, and that deception is what ultimately killed legalization's momentum. So in a way, this failure is social justice's fault, and that's not to discount Senator Rice's efforts. They needed 21 votes to pass in the Senate, and only got 19 in large part thanks to the senator's tenacity. He whipped up enough no votes and successfully staved off the establishment. I mean, you gotta respect such a Herculean effort, so kudos. But New Jersey's news media going overboard in its coverage did far more harm than good, at least in my opinion. Now hear me out. On paper, New Jersey is bright blue, mega progressive, and super woke. Yeah, that's nonsense. New Jersey is far more conservative than it lets on, but when it comes down to brass tacks, politically it's the establishment's playground, which is how we ended up with Governor Murphy, who came in talking all the progressive SJW BS, and New Jersey's news media got in line. But what they failed to realize is that by forcing a governor on us instead of one coming up through the ranks organically, it squashed any pretext of a mandate. So where he ran on an entirely progressive platform, he doesn't have the political cachet to pull it off so smoothly, and the media going apeshit over the issue, building sites and doing countdowns, it can easily come across as antagonistic to those against and patronizing to those indifferent. And that oversaturation of the issue is why I believe social justice had such a major role in the defeat, because it was and remains a lie. The only reason cannabis corporatization was such a priority is because this state desperately needs the tax revenue, and being honest about it instead of pretending to be about altruism would have been a better strategy, because despite being a nanny state, Jersey's full of adults that recognize what's taken place, how much more freaking expensive the state in general has become, and God forbid they actually make the kind of spending cuts necessary to get the Garden State back on the right fiscal track. So, where does it go from here? I can't tell you. There is talk of a ballot question, or coming back to vote on it at a later date and time, so we'll see. But this video is really just me venting, because all of this could have been avoided if there was a smidgen more honesty coming from our electeds and the media that covers them, instead of trying to make the moral case, just make the logical one. So, with that being said, please, do all the internet stuff. Like, sub, share, speak. What do you think was the biggest detraction? How can you not respect the hell out of Senator Rice? When do you think legalization will get done? Feel free to yell at me in the comments. And until the next video, love.